I have a senior in high school who's currently looking into college options.
They might allow freshmen to come back though.
I have a freshman in high school who is enjoying the whole high school experience and doing lots of sports. How was school today?
Good.
Yeah, and then I also have a second grader girl who is adopted from Vietnam. So I'm definitely on the go quite a bit. My boys are water polo players and a swimmer and a diver, and so there's lots of time spent in bleachers. And it would get uncomfortable after a while just sitting in the bleachers, but never really thought that it was related to anything. I certainly had bloating and I had lots of cramping and I had some back pain, but I guess I didn't necessarily think that it was fibroids.
But the diagnosis was clear, fibroids.
So fibroids are benign growths of the uterus, and they develop into a mass that can grow either inside the uterus or on the surface of the uterus. So depending on the location and the size, that determines what symptoms the patients will have.
And once the cause of her pain had a name, it sounded all too familiar to Karen.
Well, my mom had a hysterectomy when she was 39 because she had a fibroid the size of a grapefruit and had a lot of symptoms from that.
Low back pain, pelvic pain, bladder pain, just feeling kind of bloated. We see women with heavy bleeding. Probably the majority of women have fibroids at some point detected in their life. The question is whether they're being bothered by symptoms of fibroids, because most women, even with pretty significant fibroids, don't have many symptoms. For most women, just observation is the only thing that they need.
But Karen knew, in her case, she needed a way to relieve her symptoms.
So I did go see a specialist, and she said that basically my only option was a hysterectomy. Just the thought of actually having an organ removed when it wasn't necessarily required. And especially given what my mom went through with her hysterectomy, I didn't necessarily want to go that route. So I did feel like I had to, you know, maybe do some research myself and see what the options were. Come on, guys.
And that's when Karen saw an article about a new non-surgical treatment option.
So with radiofrequency ablation, we're not actually removing the fibroid. We're treating the fibroid, and that fibroid will shrink and allows us to direct the energy only to the fibroid and not treat normal uterine tissue.
Once I had the procedure, even though there's a little bit of recovery time from that, the symptoms, you know, went away right away, so I could really feel a difference. Can you play this one? Yeah, my daughter's 8 now, but she still occasionally likes to be picked up and carried around, and it's certainly much easier when I don't have the back pain. Will he fetch if you throw a stick for him? The two dogs are a new addition, but it's certainly nice to be able to run around with them as well.
And this peace of mind and body only took a bit of research.
Definitely seek out your options.
With fibroids specifically, the number of treatment options that are available has grown exponentially in the last few years, and it really has helped patients who wanted to avoid hysterectomy be able to do so.
But Karen isn't alone. This story hits close to home because I had a fibroid removed too. Fibroids are actually very common, but it seems to me the uncommon part is talking about them.
Fibroids are sort of hush-hush in, you know, among society, among communities. Like, you tell a girlfriend, like, I am too.
Because of that issue, they don't bring it up to the physician. They think there's a wide variation of how much bleeding women think is normal. And we frequently see patients coming in through the emergency room having passed out and with such a low blood count that it's very dangerous for them, while they thought that their periods were normal, and their periods clearly are not normal.
So Karen's procedure was a little bit different than my procedure. Why did you choose what you did for her versus what you did for me?
So first, radiofrequency ablation is a new technology. But also, the major factor is where you are in your childbearing. And with Karen, she had completed her family. And there are many women who come in and say, look, I never want to buy a tampon again. If I ever buy a pad or a tampon again, I'm going to scream. I never want to do it again. Just take out my uterus. And for that patient, hysterectomy is a great option.
Me hearing hysterectomy, I'm like, no, because I still want to have kids.
Right.
And so for people like me, or people that have already, you know, had children but want to have more, there are other options to do.
Exactly.
And we shouldn't be afraid of fibroids.
Don't be afraid of fibroids.
And it's okay to talk about.
That's right.